objective in this study was to see if we could detect any patterns in shifts of bloom time ranging back from 1966, which is the first record we have of the cherry trees on campus, up until present day. Our intention with the data that we've collected, with the help of many, many volunteers, is to use the fine scale data we have on the way the trees progress through budding and creating a model that inputs temperature data and links that temperature data to the developmental stage of the trees with the goal of predicting bloom time in the future. We generated that data in two different ways. One is that we scoured newspaper records, and then we used volunteers beginning in 2012 to collect data on the ground.
So I can see that these are already in a green bud stage.
And then so using all of that data, we mapped weather data on top of it to see, you know, how, if at all, that was driving the timing of the bloom. And what we found in Seattle, which is surprising to me, is because our winters are so mild and warm, there's actually been a delay in the bloom time over the past six decades, as in the bloom time is getting a little bit later, shifting a little bit later. Cherry trees require both a what we call chilling and a warming period. And so they require a certain amount of cold until a certain threshold and then a certain amount of warmth to successfully bloom. Due to our mild winters in the Pacific Northwest, it's taking longer for these trees to accumulate the chilling units that they need to reach that threshold and begin moving through the bloom stages. Quite accurate. We were happy. We were within a two-day range of peak bloom, and that's 70% of the blossoms on a tree in flower. What I would love to see is if we can use the model we've created and input different climate scenarios to forecast even farther forward under a continually changing climate.